Children are unique computational entities. They have at least twice as many neural connections as adults do. By age 3, this could amount to 1,000 trillion synapses. But it's not just about quantity, it's about quality. Kids have an incredibly high rate of learning and adaptation. Unlike us, they easily memorize things on the first try. What is this secret? It is high neuroplasticity in the brain. The better the plasticity, the easier it is to rewire neural connections and create new ones. That is what memory is. The less plasticity there is, the harder it is to rewire the brain. Kids have maximum plasticity, while adults have minimum. But why? Because for effective interaction with the environment, humans need stable, not plastic neural connections. This reduces cognitive load and saves energy. You don't have to consciously think about driving, running, shutting a door, kicking a ball, or articulating words. Your brain handles this subconsciously because it already has the right connections. Children don't have such connections. Their brains are blank slates. However, for survival, there is a need to form these connections rapidly. Hence, a child's brain is like a sponge, eagerly soaking up any information. They don't need effort. They automatically remember many things they see. It's like furnishing a room. The process is much faster if it's empty than if it's already filled. So, what should we do to learn something new? What if we need to change the furniture in our apartment? Effort and focus are needed. We can't memorize everything. It's too costly. We can only remember what's truly important. When we focus our attention on something, it signals the brain to increase plasticity and rewire. The longer an adult can maintain focus, the higher their brain plasticity, and the quicker they memorize important information. The older a person gets, the lower their brain plasticity, but the better they focus. It's a compensatory mechanism. Adults have poor plasticity but good focus, whereas children find it hard to focus but have high plasticity. Your ability to focus improves over time. The longer you practice it, the better you get. Two factors significantly help in this: reward and stress. Let's start with reward. Every time you receive a reward after an action, it enhances your focus on that activity. You instantly remember what brings you pleasure and want more of it. That's why instant gratifications like sweet food, alcohol, pornography, or drugs quickly rewire the brain and form harmful habits. In theory, if you give a person $100 for drawing or reading each time, they will focus on those activities. However, this focus will last only as long as the $100 keep coming. If you stop providing the reward, the motivation will vanish. The next more reliable factor is short-term stress. People can accomplish a lot to eliminate what irritates them. Students before exams or foreigners in a new language environment can memorize large volumes of information very quickly. That's because if you find yourself in an uncomfortable situation, there's an evolutionary reason to remember both the situation itself and the ways to escape it. This might come in handy if the situation recurs. Thus, stress enhances your brain's plasticity. Stress is an excellent learning tool because it can be easily simulated through physical workouts or as a result of making mistakes. I regularly employ both methods. Let's start with physical workouts, as they are easier to apply. Any physical workout is stressful for our bodies because it disrupts the equilibrium of our internal environment. Strength training, running, cycling, swimming, and walking stimulate the production of stress hormones like cortisol, thereby enhancing the memorization of new information. Some scientists even argue that the brains of all mammals evolve primarily to manage physical movement of the body. The larger the brain, the more complex actions it can coordinate. Physical movement activates brain plasticity and memory retention. Historically, such movement indicated that the person had entered new territory with new risks for survival. The faster our ancestors memorized new coordinates, dangers, traps, and safe places, the greater were their chances of survival. Any physical workout enhances brain plasticity. However, aerobic exercises like running or walking do it more effectively. The next form of useful stress is making mistakes. Nobody likes to make mistakes or appear foolish. Why? Because a person who makes many mistakes tends to have poor knowledge. Historically, those with poor knowledge were more likely to die than those who were better informed. That's why it's so unpleasant to make mistakes. At that moment, cortisol is released into your system, enhancing your memory. There is an evolutionary need to avoid making mistakes. Your learning process absolutely requires feedback, so you can identify your mistakes and activate your brain. Consider how to organize this. Now let's discuss how any skill is formed. This process always consists of two stages: input and output, consumption and practice. Let's start with input. At this stage, you consume and memorize new information. This can take many forms: listening to a lecture, reading a book, watching a video, conversing with AI, or studying Google search results. Everything we discussed earlier, attention focus, stress, physical workouts, and mistakes should be utilized at this stage, because all of these factors increase brain plasticity and help you quickly memorize a lot of new information. The second stage is output. Only after you've memorized the necessary information can you retrieve it from memory and apply it in practice. Input and output don't mesh well together because they are opposing processes. Stress, mistakes, and focus help you memorize information but hinder your ability to think deeply. The second stage, output, requires conscious thinking, yet stress tends to suppress it. It is counterproductive to force students to speak a new language from the first lesson. How can you produce output if you've skipped the input? How can you think in a new language when your mind is stressed? The ideal routine should be sequential. First, the student consumes information for an extended period, then attempts to practice it. During physical training, you might listen to formulas, a foreign language, or traffic rules. Stress enhances your memory. Later, in a calm state, you try to solve equations, speak the new language, or drive a car. Stress helps to memorize, but suppresses thinking. All right, let's summarize. Adults have three main ways to increase neuroplasticity: prolonged focus of attention, positive reinforcement in the form of rewards, and stress-induced anxiety. Every time you make mistakes or engage in physical workouts, you enhance the brain's ability to memorize information. This should be incorporated into your daily routine. To master any skill, you first need to consume and memorize information, and only then try to retrieve and use it. Well, what's up next? In the next story, we'll discuss your diet. You will stop eating sugar after watching the next video. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. I wish you a calm mind, a fit body, love, and go forth.